Africa, welcome to Daybreak Africa from the Voice of America. I'm James Bate in Washington. Today is Friday, December 14th, and here are some of the stories we're covering. Cameroon President Paul Biya grants clemency to 289 people from the country's volatile English-speaking region. The separatists say the clemency has no bearing on their push for an independent Anglophone Cameroon. The separatist Ambazonia Movement of Cameroon says President Paul Biya's clemency to 289 people from the English-speaking regions of the country has no bearing on the group's desire for an independent Anglophone Cameroon, which they call Ambazonia. Chris Anu, Secretary of State for Communication of the self-proclaimed Ambazonia interim government, says President Biya's move is a mere window dressing because the government is still holding more than 3,000 people from English-speaking Cameroon, including about 47 separatist leaders.
Paul Biya has over 3,000 Ambazonians abducted into detention centers in French Cameroon. And does he expect us to start dancing when out of over 3,000, he is putting out only 289? Yaoundé alone has close to 1,000. Douala, we don't know the numbers there. Bamenda has over 600. Boya has over 600. We don't know those in Bafoussam, I mean in Mbunda, in Chan. And we should be happy with 289. So that doesn't move us, and we think that is just window dressing.
You have said that nothing President Paul Biya does will change the determination of your group towards independence. So this should not bother you there.
No, again, it doesn't bother us. Even if our leaders were released among the 289, that doesn't change anything because this struggle has always been there before they were picked up. And again, we should not forget, they were abducted. These people ought not to be behind bars in the first place. Now, tell me, how do you charge somebody into a military tribunal in the first place if his sins are only misdemeanors? That is a question everybody should be asking the regime in French Cameroon. So again, this is window dressing.
We spoke with the Minister of Information, Isachiro Mabakari, and he said that this clemency of the 289 did not include the leaders of your movement because your leaders took up arms against the state of Cameroon.
Well, French Cameroon has to prove that our leaders picked up arms. Our leaders were abducted in Nigeria, under the custody of the United Nations High Commission for Refugees in Nigeria. So they should not be under French Cameroon custody, whether they release them or not. Again, that doesn't stop us from prosecuting this war to the end.
Don't you think President Paul Biya deserves some credit for what he's doing?
He's the president of French Cameroon. He is not the president for Ambazonia. The president for Ambazonia is Sisiko Julius Ayoktare, and we are asking for his unconditional release.
I wanted to ask you, Chris, I saw that the Ambazonia have their own currency now. What does that mean?
I won't comment on that right now. In the future, I will.
Thank you very much, Chris. It's so nice to talk with you.
Thank you, sir. My pleasure.
Chris Anu is Secretary of State for Communication of the Ambazonian Separatist Movement of Cameroon, who is speaking with me from the U.S. city of Houston in Texas. You're listening to Daybreak Africa on the Voice of America. I'm James Barton in Washington. Today is Friday, December 14th.